Hey guys, it's Chef Tom here. Today we're gonna discuss grilling, broiling, and rotisserie. This is a multi-part series where we will discuss how to cook anything. I'll put a list up on the screen about all the other cooking methods that we'll discuss. Having a fundamental understanding of the different cooking methods will give you confidence in knowing how to cook anything. So let's get started. Number one, grilling. When you're grilling, you're cooking from a radiant heat that is below. There's grill grates, there's high heat. So the things that you're gonna wanna grill are tender cuts of meat, like ribeyes, beef tenderloin, New York strips, chicken breast, chicken thigh, pork chops. You can use tougher cuts of meat, like say flank steak, but you're gonna wanna make sure it's thin. Sturdy pieces of fish, like tuna, swordfish, salmon. Vegetables like broccoli, onions, peppers. There's a lot of different vegetables you can use. Grilling kind of produces like a smoky flavor from the juices that drip from whatever you're cooking. The fat that comes out of the meat will hit the burner plate and smoke, and that kind of creates like a smoky flavor. Also, the flavor that comes off the grill grates that goes onto the meat or the vegetables kind of gives it that smoky flavor. So there's a couple different kinds of grills. You have like gas grills and wood grills. You can use like mesquite or cherry wood or hickory or charcoal even. So when you're grilling, you want to preheat the grill so it's nice and hot and ready to go when you put your items on there. Typically with grills, you'll have different hot spots. Usually the center's hotter, or just depending, like each grill has its own like little quirks to it. You might have a hot section and like colder section, even if they're on full blast. You'll kind of figure that out once you get used to knowing your grill. But that comes in handy because you're gonna wanna have like different sections. Like you're gonna have a hot section that you're gonna want to sear the meat on. Usually like when you're searing meat on a grill, you want it to be as hot as you can get it so that you get that nice caramelization on the outside. So you sear the meat and you got the nice browning that you want on the outside. Now you just wanna cook it a little bit more. Those are gonna be for like kind of medium thick cuts. And then like your cold section can be for finishing off meat or even holding it off to the side just to keep it hot until you serve it. You're gonna wanna make sure that your grates on your grill are nice and clean beforehand. You'll get it hot, get the grill nice and hot, brush it with a grill brush. You can take like a towel and wipe the grates clean so that you don't get any of that charcoal residue on your food. And then you can even brush it with like an oily towel, put a little oil on a towel and rub the grill grates with that, and it'll help prevent sticking. So preparing your food for the grill, you're gonna wanna pre-season it, pre-oil it. You can use pan spray to help it from not sticking on the grill. You can marinate meat and vegetables before you put it on there, but make sure that you let any excess marinade drip off before you apply to the grill. Otherwise, you're gonna get a lot of smoke. That leads me to another point. If you have excess oil or marinade dripping off the meat, that section is going to get really smoky and you're going to have like a soot layer on your food, and you don't want that. So make sure that you let any marinades drip off before you put them on the grill. In order to achieve the Maillard reaction, which is the browning and caramelization of meat, you're going to need to make sure that your meat is dry. Any moisture that's on the meat is going to prevent it from having any browning. So when you put your meat and vegetables on there, you kind of want to just put it on there and then let it do its thing. You don't want to touch it. You don't want to poke at it. You'll want to leave it on there for at least a couple minutes, like 1-2 minutes at the very least, depending on how hot your grill is. But getting your grill nice and hot is going to prevent your meat and vegetables from sticking. The more you play around with the meat or you try to like peel it off, you're gonna have stickiness. Let it sit there for a couple of minutes until you kind of notice the edge that's touching the hot side. You'll see like some browning happening there, and that's when it's appropriate to flip the meat. Like say if you're trying to put cross hatch or diamond marks on a steak, I'll usually let it brown on one side, then flip it so that I get even cooking on both sides. And then I'll flip it at like a 90 degree angle so you achieve those really nice looking diamond marks. So really thin cuts of meat you're gonna wanna cook on the hot section, so that you get that nice charring on the outside, but the meat in the middle doesn't cook as much. Like say you have a thicker piece of meat, you can sear that off on the really hot section, then kind of move it over to like the medium heat section to let that like heat kind of penetrate in there. Lower heat will have more penetrating effect, where you're not burning the outside of the meat, and you're getting more of like, the more time you give it, the more penetration of heat will get to the middle. Otherwise, you'll have like a really burnt outside and a completely rare inside. You can also grill something, like say like a prime rib, and get it really nice and charred on the outside, and then throw it in the oven and let it cook in the oven for like an hour or whatever at like a lower heat. You can grill chicken breasts and maybe put like some nice crosshatch diamond marks on it, and then finish that in the oven too. If you're working in a professional setting, it'll help you with your time management. So you have like 200 chicken breasts you wanna cook. You throw them on the grill, get some nice, pretty marks on them, put them on a sheet tray, and then throw them in the oven. It's just an efficient way of working in a professional kitchen, but it can also apply at home. So you have a thicker piece of meat, you wanna get that nice char on the outside and then finish it in a cooler environment so that you're not burning the outside. Also with grills, some of them will have lids, like an outside grill. You can close the grill and then that creates a hot environment where the air is kind of circulating around in there and it's hitting the meat and vegetables from the other side that's not touching the grill grates. Kind of like the effect of an oven. If you're applying something like a barbecue sauce or any other kind of sauce, you're gonna wanna do that towards the end, because if you apply it too soon, it's gonna burn, especially something like barbecue sauce that has a lot of sugar in it. Things that have sugar in there will burn very easily. You're gonna wanna have consistent thickness throughout whatever you're cooking, just so that they finish at a proper time. Otherwise, you're gonna wanna take off the thinner items before you take off the thicker items, just cause the thicker items need more time to cook. You can add some extra flavor to items by having like say a smoker box or a pouch of tin foil. You can put hardwood chips in there or herb stems, and that'll like impart their flavors throughout the cooking. You put them in a smoking box so that they don't ignite. Broiling is very similar to grilling, except that it has extreme radiant heat coming from above. In most professional environments I've been in, they either call it a salamander, or it'll be underneath like say a flat top where you have like grill grate that you pull out and you put the steak on and you slide it back in. And then, so you have like the grill grate here, you have the like flames right here, and in between you have that meat that you're cooking, and it's like that far away from the flame, and it's like an enclosed environment, so you have like a lot of like heat. Besides the flames that are directly above it, that whole environment is like super hot, like 700 degrees or even more. And what that does is it gives it a really hot environment where you can get a nice crispy brown very quickly. At home, your oven has a broil setting on there, which is basically the highest heat that your oven will get to. Instead of the element on the bottom heating up, you have the element on the very top heating up. You're gonna get that kind of crispiness. If you want like to get something really nice and crispy really quickly, that's what you're gonna do. When broiling, you're gonna wanna put things like in pie tins, or a commercial like salamander or broiler may have like grill grates on there where you can put the meat directly on that. Or you can get a nice metal plate, oil it, put your fish on there, throw it in the broiler. It'll be cooked in like 3 to 5 minutes, depending on the thickness. You're not gonna wanna cook really thick items in the broiler from start to finish. You can use it to melt cheese or get a little nice caramelization on the very top of something. You're gonna wanna use tender cuts when you're broiling, because that dry heat's really gonna dry out whatever you're cooking. You're gonna have a really burnt outside and like a rare inside. So while we're on the topic of grilling and broiling, you also have spit roasting and rotisserie, which is putting meat on a skewer and kind of rotating it around, getting that dry heat environment, penetrating that meat. It's very similar to the grilling broiling technique. You have that radiant heat, they're rotating, so they're kind of like turning and getting like kind of almost like a basting effect from their juices just kind of circulating around. Well, I hope you found that video informational. Stick around, watch the other videos on how to cook anything. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe.